Today we discuss some problems on quadratic equation, in which the first problem, what is given? The roots of the equation q minus r into x square plus r minus p into x plus p minus q is equal to 0. So in this problem we need roots. So, how to get the roots of the given quadratic equation? Observe, when compare with the standard form of quadratic equation, what is standard form of quadratic equation? Standard form of quadratic equation, nothing but a x square plus b x plus c is equal to 0. Compare given equation with the standard form, then the value of a, nothing but a is equal to q minus r, b is equal to r minus p, c is equal to p minus q. And then observe here a plus b plus c. So let us consider a plus b plus c. A nothing but q minus r plus r minus p plus p minus q. Minus q plus q getting cancelled, minus r plus r getting cancelled, plus p minus p getting cancelled. So indirectly all terms should be getting cancelled, the value should be 0. So a plus b plus c is equal to 0. Last class we discuss, in the quadratic equation f of x is equal to x square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, a plus b plus c is equal to 0, then the roots are 1 comma c by a. So therefore, the required roots are 1 comma c by a. So implies 1 comma c, nothing but p minus q, divided by a, nothing but q minus r. So these are the roots of the given quadratic equation. Now we move to second problem. What is given? Product of the roots of the equation x square minus 5kx plus 2 into e to the power of 4 log k minus 1 is equal to 0 is 31. Then we need sum of the roots. Originally sum of the roots formula, alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. So alpha plus beta in this quadratic equation 5k. Here we don't know the value of k. So first of all, we can calculate the value of k using the given condition. So what is given condition? Product of the roots is 31. So product of the roots, nothing but alpha into beta. Alpha into beta is equal to c by a is equal to 31. So alpha into beta c by a, what is c here? 2 into e to the power of 4 log k minus 1 is equal to 31. Minus 1 taken into RHS side, it becomes to plus 32. So 2 into e to the power of 4 log k is equal to 32. So 2 1s, 2 16s. So therefore, e to the power of 4 log k is equal to 16. Now here is a some basic. In logarithm we know that what are the basics. M into log a, m into log a base e is equal to log a to the power of m base e. That is one basic. Second basic, e to the power of log x base e, the value should be x. Using these two formulas we can derive this solution. So now we can write e to the power of m log a, means log a power m, means logarithm of k to the power of 4 base e is equal to 16. Now indirectly it is in the form e power log x base c. E power log x base c value x. Compare with the basic, here x should be k to the power of 4. So therefore k to the power of 4 is equal to 16, but 16 can be written as 2 power 4. Therefore k is equal to 2. When we know the k value, what we need in this problem? Sum of the roots. So therefore sum of the roots is equal to alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. Alpha plus beta by data, it is nothing but 5 times of k, 5 into k. So therefore alpha plus beta is equal to 5 into 2, that is equal to 10. This is your answer. Now we go to another question, third one. What is given in this problem? The roots of the equation x square minus bx plus c is equal to 0, be two consecutive integers. Then we need the value of b square minus 4a, 4c value. So consecutive integers means, for example, 1, 2 or 2, 3 or 4, 5. Whatever it may be, two consecutive integers we can consider. But two consecutive integers differ by 1. So the roots of the quadratic equation be two consecutive integers. So therefore, first of all, given quadratic equation, nothing but x square minus bx plus c is equal to 0. So using data, consecutive integers are the roots. Modulus of alpha minus beta value should be 1. So if you consider 1, if you consider 2, difference must be minus 1. But its modulus value nothing but 1. If you consider 2, if you consider 1, so difference should be 1. So its value should be 1. But last classes we discussed what is modulus of alpha minus beta. Modulus of alpha minus beta, it is nothing but square root over b square minus 4ac divided by mod a is equal to 1. Now what is a, what is b, what is c in the given quadratic equation? A value 1, b value minus b, c value c. So root over b square means minus b whole square means b square, 4ac, a means 1, c means c, so 4c divided by a 1 is equal to 1. So for cancelling square root, squaring on both sides, after squaring it becomes to b square minus 4c is equal to 1. What we need in this problem? B square minus 4c value. So b square minus 4c value should be 1. Next, come to another one. What is problem given? In triangle PQR, we know that in any triangle sum of angles must be 180 degrees. Here named the triangle is PQR. So P plus Q plus R is equal to 180. And also given angle R is equal to 90. In any triangle, one angle must be 90, so it is right angle triangle. So one angle 90, sum of remaining two angles also 90, reason total sum of angles is equal to 180 in triangle. And tan P by 2, tan Q by 2 are the angles, are the roots of AX square plus BX plus C is equal to 0 and A naught equal to 0. Here what we want means we need a relation between A, B, C. So how to get? Now in triangle APQR, sum of angles P plus Q plus R is equal to 180. Since angle R is equal to 90, angle R is equal to 90 implies P plus Q is equal to 90. Now what we need, tan p by 2 tan q by 2 are the roots of the given quadratic equation. Here there are angles p by 2 q by 2. We know that these are sub multiple angles. P by 2 and q by 2 are sub multiples. So we want to convert p plus q is equal to 90 into p by 2 and q by 2 means this one divisible by 2 on both sides. When it is divisible by 2, it becomes to p by 2 plus q by 2 is equal to 90 by 2, that is equal to 45. Here are the ratios, tangent ratios. So we are taking tangent function on both sides, then it becomes to tan over p by 2 plus q by 2 is equal to tan 45. Tan 45, nothing but 1. So now it is in the form tan of a plus b. So what is tan of a plus b? Tan a plus tan b by 1 minus tan a into tan b. So let us apply. Tan a means tan p by 2, tan b means tan q by 2 divided by 1 minus tan a into tan b. Tan a into tan b mean tan p by 2 into tan q by 2. Now indirectly it is in the form sum of the roots of this quadratic equation. Reason for this quadratic equation, these are the roots, means it is sum of the roots and this is product of the roots. What is sum of the roots? Minus b by a. Product of the roots, nothing but c by a. So we know that tan p by 2 plus tan q by 2. Tan p by 2 plus tan q by 2, nothing but minus b by a. And tan p by 2 into tan q by 2, it is nothing but c by a. We are substituting sum of the roots and the product of the roots in this one. We get minus b by a whole divided by 1 minus c by a is equal to 1. So denominator LCM is a, then it becomes to a minus c by a. So both numerator and denominator after LCM a getting cancelled. So what is remaining? So remaining is nothing but minus b divided by a minus c is equal to 1. Taking cross multiply, minus b is equal to a minus c. Now minus b taken into RHS side, minus c taken into LHS side. So therefore c is equal to a plus b. So this is the relation using the condition. Now we go to another problem. What is given? P comma q be the roots of this quadratic equation. In this quadratic equation, there is one unknown capital A, and R comma S be the roots of quadratic equation. In this quadratic equation, there is unknown B. Condition P less than Q less than R less than S are in arithmetic progression, then we need ordered pair A comma B. Just simple, what we get in this problem? A and B. To get the value of A, so first of all we can calculate either P or Q or both. Next, same, to get the value of B, so first we can calculate R comma S. Reason, R into S, product of the roots B. Here product of the roots nothing but capital A. So how to calculate P, Q or S means using the given condition. P less than Q less than R less than S, which are in AP. So when compared to Q, P is nothing but lesser value. Similar manner, when compared to R, Q is lesser value. When compared to S, R is lesser value. So now using data, what is data? P comma Q comma R comma S are in arithmetic progression. We know that arithmetic progression series nothing but A plus D, A plus 2D, A plus 3D to be continued A plus n minus 1 into d. So in arithmetic progression, what are the points we have to observe? If given series which are in arithmetic progression, the common difference must be similar. So what is common difference? A2 minus A1, A3 minus A2, A4 minus A3, and so on, AN minus AN minus 1. If common difference equal, now the series is in arithmetic progression. Now, using that condition, PQR is in arithmetic progression, let us consider the value of P and Q and R and S as A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D, A plus 3D. Let us observe, when compared to P, Q, R, S, what is data? P less than, Q less than, R less than, S. So, A minus 3D less than A minus D less than A plus D less than A plus 3D. So, this condition is clear. And we have to check, this is A1, A2, A3, A4. A2 minus A1. It is nothing but A minus D minus of A minus 3D. A getting cancelled, 2D. Let us check A3 minus A2. A getting cancelled, D minus of minus D, 2D. A4 minus A3. A getting cancelled, 3D minus D, 2D. So, common difference are equal. Now, P, Q, R, S are in arithmetic progression. So, in your mind, for the respective problem, P, comma, Q are the roots of first equation, means A minus 3D, comma, A minus D are the roots of this equation. So, therefore, A minus 3D, comma, A minus D are the roots of x square minus 2x plus capital A is equal to 0. Now here, if you consider sum of the roots, it's nothing but plus 2. Product of the roots, nothing but capital A. Next, R comma S are the roots of the second equation, means A plus D comma A plus 3D are the roots of second equation, x square minus 18x plus capital B is equal to 0. Now, to get the value of A, D, so we know the roots of the equation. How to get? Let us consider sum of the total roots. Now, consider P plus Q plus R plus S. P plus Q plus R plus S means sum of the roots of the first equation, it is nothing but 2. And Q plus R, nothing but sum of the roots of the second equation, nothing but 18. But P plus Q plus R, P plus Q plus R plus S means A plus A plus A plus A, 4A. Minus 3D plus 3D cancel. Minus D plus D getting cancelled, so it becomes to 4 times of A. So, 4 times of A is nothing but 20, implies the value of A is equal to 5. So, we know the value of A only. Now, we find D common difference, how to get. Now, consider P plus Q. P plus Q for the first equation are R plus S, P plus Q plus R plus S. Now, we can calculate sum of the roots, P plus Q. P plus Q is nothing but from the first equation 2. So, P plus Q means A minus 3D plus A minus D means 2A minus 4D is equal to 2. Now, 2 common and getting cancelled, A minus 2D. It is nothing but 1. But we know the value of A. So a value nothing but 5. So 5 minus 2d is equal to 1 implies the value of d nothing but 2. So we know the d value, a value. Whenever we know the a, d, we get all the roots of the given quadratic equation. So therefore, the roots of the quadratic equation. So therefore, roots are p, q, r and s. So what is p, what is q, what is r and what is s? P nothing but a minus 3d, a minus 3d. A value 5, d value 2, means 5 minus 3, 2 are 6. So the value of p nothing but minus 1. Next, a minus d, 5 minus 2 means 3. Next, r value, a plus d means 5 plus 2, nothing but 7. S nothing but a plus 3d, 5 plus 3, 2 are 6. So it becomes to 11. So we know the p, q, r, s. What we need in this problem? A and b. How to get a? A is nothing but product of the roots. So therefore, a is equal to product of the roots of the first equation. Product of the roots of the first equation, p into q. So p into q is equal to minus 1 into 3 minus 3. B is nothing but same product of the roots of the second equation, means r into s. R into s nothing but 11 sevens are 77. Therefore, the required ordered pair a comma b nothing but minus 3 comma 77 is your answer. Now go to another problem. What is given here? x1 x3 are the roots of ax square minus 4x plus 1 is equal to 0. x2 x4 are the roots of bx square minus 6x plus 1 is equal to 0. And x1, x2, x3, x4 are in harmonic progression. Then we need ordered pair a comma b. By data for the quadratic equation, x1, x3 are in harmonic progression. By data, x1, x3 are in HP. Already we know that one class. For the quadratic equation f of x is equal to 0, roots are alpha comma beta. Then 1 by alpha, 1 by beta are the roots of f of 1 by x is equal to 0. Now, arithmetic progression, it's reciprocal nothing but harmonic progression. Vice versa, harmonic progression, reciprocal, it is nothing but arithmetic progression. So therefore, if you replace x by 1 by x in this equation, now these roots are in arithmetic progression. Here also the roots are in arithmetic progression. So let us consider the polynomial ax square minus 4x plus 1 is equal to 0. Roots are x1, x3. Now replace x by 1 by x. Replace x by 1 by x, it becomes to a by x square minus 4 by x plus 1 is equal to 0. LCM should be x square. Now, after taking LCM, it becomes to x square minus 4x plus a is equal to 0. Now, the roots are convert into arithmetic progression. Roots are in arithmetic progression, or simply the roots are 1 by x1 and 1 by x3. In the similar manner, we go to second equation. What is second equation? B times of x square minus 6 times of x plus 1 is equal to 0. Roots are by data x2 comma x4. Now replace x by 1 by x and simplify also directly. I can write x square minus 6x plus b is equal to 0 roots are 1 by x2 comma 1 by x4. Now they are in arithmetic progression. So indirectly for these two equations, roots are in arithmetic progression. We know here what we find out, capital A comma capital B. Capital A comma capital B means nothing but product of the roots, It is similar to indirectly previous problem. So how to get? Consider roots of, first equation. A x square minus 4x, plus a is equal to 0 and x square minus 6x plus b is equal to 0 or arithmetic progression now arithmetic progression, consider the roots. A minus 3d, a plus d. Now by data, what is consideration? A minus 3d and a plus d are the roots of the first equation. A minus 3d comma a plus d are the roots of x square minus 4x plus a is equal to 0, and x2 comma x4 are the roots of the second equation, means a minus d comma a plus d, are the roots of second equation, x square minus 6x plus b is equal to 0. Now let us consider some of the roots of the first equation, some of the roots of the second equation. Means indirectly we can add all these one. So therefore a minus 3d plus a plus d plus a minus d plus a plus 3d, it is nothing but 4 plus 6. 3d getting cancelled, dd getting cancelled implies 4a value should be 10, implies the value of a, it is nothing but 10 by 4, nothing but 5 by 2. And next, consider some of the roots of the any first equation or second equation. So a minus 3d plus a plus d is equal to plus 4. Minus 3d plus d, nothing but minus 2d. So we get 2a minus 2d is equal to 4. 2 common and getting cancelled. So therefore a minus d is equal to 2. So what is the value of a? 5 by 2. So therefore 5 by 2 minus d is equal to 2. So implies the value of d is nothing but 5 by 2 minus 2, that is equal to 1 by 2. So therefore the roots of the equation, a minus 3d, a plus d, their product nothing but capital A. So therefore capital A is nothing but product of the roots, means a minus 3d into a plus d. What is a? A nothing but 5 by 2, d nothing but 1 by 2, means 5 by 2 minus 3 by 2, nothing but 2 by 2, its value is 1. Next, a plus d, nothing but 5 by 2 plus 1 by 2, 6 by 2, nothing but 3, so a value should be 3. Next, to get the value of b. So b is nothing but product of the second equation, means a minus d into a plus 3d. So what is a? 5/2. 5/2 minus 1/2, that is nothing but 4/2, nothing but 2. A plus 3d means 5/2 plus 3 into 1/2, nothing but 4. So 2 4s are 8. So therefore required ordered pair a comma b nothing but 3 comma 8. Another problem, x, a, b, c are real numbers and x minus a plus b whole square plus x minus b plus c whole square is equal to 0. Then a, b, c are in. A, b, c are in means nothing but are in arithmetic progression or geometrical progression or harmonic progression, we have to calculate. Indirectly it is in the form x minus a plus b whole square plus x minus b plus c whole square is equal to 0. So indirectly capital A square plus capital B square is equal to 0 model. A square plus B square is equal to 0 when it is to be possible means only when A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 0. So x minus A, x minus A plus B whole square plus x minus B plus C whole square is equal to 0. So this is in the form A square plus B square is equal to 0. It is true only when A is equal to B is equal to 0 only. Now A is equal to 0 means x minus A plus B is equal to 0. B is equal to 0 means x minus B plus C is equal to 0. Now I can from this one I can consider the value of x. The value of x nothing but a minus b. Reason, minus a taken into RHS side, plus b taken into RHS side. Same from this one also x value should be b minus c. So here it is x, here it is x. So both values are equal. So if these two are equal, their RHS are also equal. So therefore I can write a minus b is equal to b minus c. From this one, 2b is equal to a plus c. So we know that arithmetic progression condition, for any three numbers a, b, c are in arithmetic progression, then 2b is equal to a plus c. So here 2b is equal to a plus c means now a comma b comma c are in arithmetic progression. So solution of this problem. Now go to ninth question. So what is about ninth question? What is given? Alpha beta are the roots of x minus a into x minus b plus c is equal to 0. Alpha comma beta are the roots of alpha comma beta are the roots of x minus a into x minus b plus c is equal to 0. It's a simplification. We know that x square minus x of a plus b plus ab plus c is equal to 0. Whenever for any quadratic equation roots are known, that we know that sum of the roots and the product of the roots. So sum of the roots nothing but alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a is equal to a plus b, and product of the roots alpha into beta, it is nothing but ab plus c. This is from the given problem first line condition. Alpha comma beta are the roots of the quadratic equation. What we need in this problem? We need roots of the equation. Now how to get the roots of the given equation? So first, given quadratic equation. So given quadratic equation, x minus c minus alpha into x minus c minus beta is equal to c. Just for the sake of our convenience, x minus c is equal to some y. So let x minus c is equal to y. If you consider x minus c is equal to y, now the given quadratic equation reduced to y minus alpha into y minus beta is equal to c. Now let us take product. Its product should be y square minus y times of alpha plus beta plus alpha beta is equal to c. But we know that alpha plus beta value, alpha into beta value. We are substituting in this one, we get y square minus y into alpha plus beta value a plus b. Alpha into beta value a b plus c is equal to c. Plus c taken into LHS side, c minus c is equal to 0. Now the equation is y square minus y times of a plus b plus a b is equal to 0. We know that it's simplification, nothing but y minus a into y minus b is equal to 0. The wherefore the value of y is equal to a and the value of y is equal to b. But these are the values of y only, but we need the values of x. What is our consideration of y? Our consideration y nothing but x minus c. So therefore x minus c is equal to a one condition, x minus c is equal to b is another condition. So from this one x is equal to a plus c, x is equal to b plus c. So therefore the roots of given quadratic equation, roots of the quadratic equation x minus c minus alpha into x minus c minus beta is equal to c are a plus c comma b plus c. These are the roots of the given quadratic equation. Another question, alpha comma beta are the roots of quadratic equation. We need alpha by a beta plus b whole cube minus beta by a alpha plus b whole cube. We know that alpha and beta are the roots of the equation, means it satisfies the equation. Alpha is a root of, alpha is a root of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Means it satisfies the equation. That means a alpha square plus b alpha plus c is equal to 0. What we know that the value of a alpha plus b, so from this one we can calculate a alpha plus b value. First two terms there is a common alpha, so we get a alpha plus b plus c taken into RHS side minus c. So it becomes to a alpha plus b, it is nothing but minus c by alpha. In similar manner beta is also a root of, beta is root of quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. So it satisfies the equation, a times of beta square plus b times of beta plus c is equal to 0. Similar to this one, I can write directly the value of a beta plus b. A beta plus b is nothing but minus c by beta. So we know the a alpha plus b, a beta plus b, but what we want in this problem? We need in this problem alpha by a beta plus b whole cube minus beta divided by a alpha plus b whole cube. But a beta plus b value nothing but minus c by b. So instead of this one we can write minus c by beta. So alpha divided by minus c by beta whole cube minus beta divided by its value nothing but minus c by alpha whole cube. Power cube, so its value must be minus. So a by b by c we can write a into c by b, means alpha into beta by c, alpha into beta by c whole cube. It is minus, power odd number, so it is minus, minus of minus plus. Minus plus c by alpha, numerator, convert numerator, then it becomes to alpha by c. So its value should be alpha beta by c whole cube. So this is positive, this is negative. These two terms are getting cancelled. Answer should be 0. So alpha by a beta plus b whole cube minus beta by a alpha plus b whole cube value should be 0. Okay.